Hi, everyone, and welcome to On Stage, the Isolation Sessions. We're bringing you music from musicians across the country, no matter where they will be. They're probably at home, like the rest of us. So we are on week 5 of doing this, believe it or not. We had no idea what was going to happen when we shifted gears and moved the studio to my house. But here we are, and we have a great week lined up for you. And in case you didn't know, it's Monday. It also happens to be 420. So I am here to wish you all a happy 420. From myself and from Chewy too. Now Chewy, he imbibed a little bit too much. The dude took an edible, said it wasn't hitting him fast enough, so now he's passed out on the floor. Just kidding. Although Chewy does love the 420, as you can see by these photos. Actually, Chewy hates being dressed up, and I think that picture was taken 5 years ago, which was the last time I put him in a costume. But anyway, happy 420, kids, and celebrate responsibly. Of course, I think last year 420 here in Vancouver had approximately 60,000 people. Well, that's 60,000 people that should be staying at home and smoking or enjoying the marijuana in whatever form you do. And if you're lucky enough to live in California, the latest celebrity to jump on the marijuana bandwagon and have his own brand of the good stuff is Billy Ray Cyrus. Well, he probably got lessons from his daughter, Miley, who has been a weed advocate for quite some time. So he's got this new brand. And his quote today, I have to say, I never thought I'd be quoting Billy Ray Cyrus about marijuana on 420, but here we are. Be a Bogart. If you care, don't share. Don't pass your joint or pipe around. It's just not safe to do right now. Excellent point, Billy Ray, because I was at the dog beach in Kitsilano the other day and a bunch of damn kids, probably about 15 of them, I'm guessing they're not from the same household, we're sharing a joint, which in 2020 right now, it's pretty dumb. So don't do that. And I learned today, and I learned from the Billy Ray Cyrus article I just showed you, that to Bogart, which means when you hog the joint, actually is a reference to Humphrey Bogart, who was known for having a cigarette dangling from his mouth and never taking it out, not sharing. Not that you should share your cigarettes either, but there you go. Don't say you didn't learn something on 420 today. And one of the things that I've really been enjoying about this staying at home thing is the creativity that is happening all over the world. And I wanted to show you a video. There's tons of families gathering together and making music videos. And the latest is a family from Washington who decided to recreate a Journey video frame by frame. Now, Journey videos were never that great. They're funny watching them now, but watching a family recreate them is even funnier. So have a look. Here we stand. Both of our hearts broken in two, two, two. Sleepless nights, losing ground, I'm reaching back. What's better than an air guitar? An air keyboard, proven by the Heller family in Washington. I've had that song going through my head all day now, but now you will too. But the beauty of it, the Heller family said that they did it because they want to have something as a memento of that one time that they had to quarantine at home. So now they have that coveted item. A lot of the creativity has been around music, musicians creating new music. You probably saw the Lady Gaga concert over the weekend like I did. It was absolutely incredible. So incredible to see so many people coming together and realizing the healing power of music. And that is why we're partnered with Music Heals Canada, because music therapy is what they are all about. You can find tons of info right on their website. If you can donate, please do. But if you can't, that's okay too. Music Heals does great work right across the country, but it's also a great resource for us as we go through this tough time. And now it is time to get to the music. Capri Everitt. I don't often get to interview musicians who also hold records with the Guinness Book of Records, but here we are. Capri has a single called Breathe Out and another new single coming out this Friday. Capri, how are you?
I'm great, thanks. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Now, I know it was a few years back, but you have to explain what it is that you hold a Guinness record for.
So a few years ago, I traveled around the world to 80 countries, and I sung each country's national anthem in their national language. And kind of the whole idea behind this was to raise money for a charity called SOS Children's Villages.
Awesome stuff. When I first read that, I had to wrap my head around 80 countries, 80 anthems in their home languages. Capri, you were only 11 years old when you did that. What was that like? And what is it like now looking back on all that?
I mean, it was pretty crazy. I have no idea how I managed to memorize all 80 of the national anthems, especially since they were in 41 different languages. And there's a certain amount of pressure when you're like singing someone's national anthem, like you really don't want to screw it up. So, yeah.
Well, you did a great job with it. And of course, music is a huge part of your life, Capri. When did you discover your love of music?
I was 5 years old when my parents put me in piano lessons, and then they saw that I really liked it, and I would like always hum along to these little songs that I was writing, like as well as a five-year-old can. So, and they decided to put me in singing lessons as well, and I've been doing it ever since.
And you've been continuing on with your music during this time of self-isolation. How has the whole thing of staying home been for you, Capri?
Well, it was definitely a big adjustment at first, as it was for everyone. But actually, I've decided that this is probably good for me to spend. I'm spending like 3 hours a day singing and playing the piano and guitar. So I can see like progress with my instruments and stuff. So I'm not actually hating it. It's a little bit, lonely at times, as I'm sure everyone is feeling, but it's not the worst thing.
I know, and we will get through it. And part of getting through it for us here on stage is with music, of course. And you have a single that's out now called Breathe. Tell me a little bit about that one.
Yes, so Breathe is a song that I wrote back in December about like some things that I was going through last year, and I didn't intentionally release it during this pandemic. Like, you have to put it on this website to release it a few months in advance, so I had no idea that this was all going to happen while my song was released, but I think that it's actually probably like kind of good timing, because I feel like it's a song that people can probably relate to at the moment, is like this like struggle and this anxiety over the future and what's going to happen. So yeah.
And you have another single coming out on Friday called Caught Up. What's that one all about?
Yes. So Caught Up, it's one of my favorite songs. I think it's between Caught Up and Breathe, but it's a more upbeat kind of like slightly R&B 90s kind of feel. It's really fun. It's a super like light and fun song, and it's about just like something that my friends and I like went through in the fall. So yeah, it's a pretty fun song.
It is a great song indeed. And Capri, we want to thank you so much for joining us on the show. It's been such a pleasure to chat with you.
Thanks so much. Thanks for having me.
And if you want to find out more about Capri and her music, just go to her website. It's capriEverett.ca. And it is our pleasure to share Capri's music with you right now. Here she is, Capri Everitt.
Hi, my name is Capri Everitt, and I'm going to be singing an original song that I wrote called Caught Up, which is my favorite release so far, as well as my newest release, on April 24th. So I hope you stream it, and here it goes. Got my whole world spinning. Now you got me wishing how one day you could be mine, be mine. But it ain't that easy when you call it sweetie. You got me wondering why, oh why. See, that's a mock girl and it's getting awkward that the two of us feel this way about you, boy. What do I do? Cause I'm feeling confused. You know I'm here divided between her and you. I'm caught up, stuck in the middle. I'm caught between boy and a friend. Don't know how this is gonna end. Stuck in the middle. I wish I never had to choose. I don't know what I'm gonna lose, yeah. Caught up, yeah. Caught up, yeah. I don't know what I'm gonna lose. Next song, I'm going to sing a song that I wrote called Breathe, and I wrote it when I was going through some personal struggles last year, and I think now more than ever it's relatable, so I hope you guys can relate to it, and here it goes.
Is it a beautiful day? 'Cause the sun is shining, people smiling. Everybody's laughing and dancing. I don't think they know.
I'm so fragile, let it flare. Feeling down, feeling scared. All these voices in my head. I'm losing faith, I'm losing hope. It's getting hard to even cope. Toss and turn in my bed.
What's wrong?
Can't sleep.
singing an original song that I wrote called New York in My Mind, and it's dedicated to all those that would rather be somewhere else right now, although maybe not New York. So here we go. They say I don't know what I'm looking for. One foot on the brakes, one foot out the door. All of the lights are calling me. I wanna stay, but I wanna leave. Got big plans I'm making, no chance I'm not taking. No sleeping when I'm waking up. Oh, 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 cause these nights I'm already in New York in my mind. From house in the street, I can feel the energy every time I breathe. All of the lights around me. I'm in this city and I never wanna leave. Got big plans I'm making, no chance I'm not taking. No sleeping but no waking up. Oh, cause these nights I'm already in New York in my mind. The streetlights are calling my name as they start to shine. My room is dark, but the city never looked so bright. These nights I'm already in New York in my mind. Oh, in my mind. In my mind. City never looks so bright. I'm already in New York in my mind.
And that is the lovely and talented Capri Everitt. We want to thank Capri for sharing her music with us. If you want to find out more about Capri, just go to her website. It is CapriEverett.ca. We also want to thank you for watching, and thanks to our generous sponsor, Chambers Plan Group Insurance, for supporting us through all of this. And be sure to tune in tomorrow to find out who is on stage.